Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us here on the Red Devil Network. I am Boo Boo Bear. We're going to be doing the play-by-play. Sammy is not going to make it tonight. Pete, he's going to be here with us on Friday night. In the booth with me right now, one of our producers, one of the ladies that make it happen out here, Paige Lopez. Big shout out also to Don Wyatt, somewhere out there listening right now. Folks, here we go. It's the McCamey Badgers. It's the Rankin Red Devils. It's game time. We've got all boys and girls out here. What a great crowd we've got. Macy Cannon opens up. And the crowd goes absolutely wild. It's going to be a hostile environment. They're going to be hostile, mobile, and agile. McCamey Rankin going back and forth. Chloe Brewer, cross spike. Nothing but pay dirt. Drops a bullet. 2-0. And, you know, with this crowd, with this energy, with everything going, Rankin having the momentum early. That's going to go up into the rafters. Skylee Lofton drops dynamite onto the court. 3-0 is the score.
You can already kind of see the camera shaking here. Our fans are getting excited.
Connard with another serve. McCamey comes back with its own spike. Chloe's going to get a paw on it. It's going to go out of bounds. McCamey picks up its first point. 3-1 is the score. Now, see, I've got Skyly, and I know we had another young lady get a spike. I believe it was Brewer, wasn't it?
Yes, it was. It was Chloe Brewer.
So here we go into the dig portion. How about Ward right there? Cross spike. You know, Ward came up earlier before the game, and she said, my name is T. Money Ward.
T. Money.
Brewer with a big spike, cross court, and the Red Devils are rolling. 4-1 is the score. Expect McCamey to take a timeout soon. But I tell you what, Paige, this crowd has energized these Lady Red Devils.
Yes.
We got to figure out how to get this crowd on the road.
I'm sure once we get to playoffs, there'll be a fan bus come along.
Another mistake for the Badgers. You know, the last time we played in McCamey, McCamey played a really clean, really solid game. We did have some pretty good fans in attendance that night, but nothing like what this student section brings.
It definitely brings in energy, and you can see where it starts to get into the other team's head, and that's exactly what we want it to do.
Taylor Ramos doing what Taylor does. I tell you what, Taylor brings the noise out there.
Yes. And there's the timeout.
So at 6-1, McCamey does take that timeout.
Yes.
Paige, Lady Red Devils opening up strong, coming out hard. It is amazing what's going on. You can hear that crowd in the background.
Yes, they are getting after it, getting cheers going, getting loud.
Not just that. We're looking at about 40, 50 flags waving in the air. Parents are on their feet. Kids are on their feet. This is baby throwing kind of crowd out there. Look at there he goes into the rafters, coming back down. Is that the little bottle baby over there?
Something like that. We do want to give a shout out to Carrie Templeton,
yes,
the Booster Club. She has provided some of these flags that our fans are waving. And
well, you're being too modest for Carrie. She comes up before the game and she's like, "Hey, I've got 30, 40 flags. I want them waved. I want them out there. I want them back when it's done." But that's why they've got them. So big ups to Carrie and the Booster Club. Red Devils back on the offensive. Here comes Ward cross court. McCamey does get underneath it.
Oh,
Skylee Lofton blocks the sun right there. Boy, this is Skylee's game so far. Big serve.
Oh.
Lady Red Devils,
yes,
on the run. I'll tell you what, intimidation factor.
Yes,
huge.
Absolutely. Another
wow. Brewer just going in there, serving it up. Too hot to handle. It's this crowd. It's this atmosphere.
Wow.
It's this energy. Folks, if you're at the house tonight, get up. Come on down to the Devil's Zone and shake down the Thunder. Big spike into the net. If Skyly had connected with that one, this place would have been torn apart.
Yes.
Let me put this in the middle so we can both keep up with that. Lady Red Devils getting their things done. Number 15 for McCamey is going to serve the ball. She's going to go dead center of the court. Drops a dime in there. Hadley Fouts makes the dive. Not going to get to it in time. And it's going to be 9-3. Another big serve by McCamey with a dig. Issa Guerra. And how about Taylor Ramos bringing the heat? There goes Skyly to the corner. McCamey coming with a backcourt spike. Fouts underneath. Chloe sets. Ward's going to punch it over. Red Devils picking their opportunities. McCamey with the spike. Skyly gets underneath it. Issa with the save. And it's four hits ranking.
Too many.
Yeah, we just let that one get away right there.
That's all right.
McCamey's starting to close the gap, though. 9-4 is the score. Issa underneath. Fouts helping out. Number 20, Skyly Lofton clears out to the corner. And it's a Red Devil point. Ward in the mix.
And you know, last Wink and Buena Vista both found that hole. And McCamey hit it one time. And our girls are doing a great job. Hadley and Issa both did a great job of covering that hole right there that they kept trying to find.
Trinity Ward, team money, they say. Drops a serve to the corner. A little too hot for McCamey. 11-4 is the score. Lady Red Devils, if we can get past that 13th, 14th point, we might do something today. Ward with another serve. Tests him on the back line.
A little too hard.
And it's going to go long. 11-5. Now the score. The libero for the McCamey Badgers. Number 11 serving. It goes into the net. They've got him shook. This is where you want him. 12-5 is the score. That's going to bring up the junior, Skyly Lofton. Can you believe that pays? We get another year of Skyly.
I know, it's so exciting.
Connor with a big spike. McCamey does clear things out. And it's going to be a carry. Momentum going our way. Now, the crowd into it. I hope they don't get worn down because they are just active. 13-5 is the score. Rankin with an opportunity.
Oh, and miscommunication there.
Yeah, Hadley and Skyly kind of looked at each other like, hey, what's going on? So it's 13-6, little mistake right there, but you know what? It's a game. Those things happen.
Yeah.
And that's going to bring up number 18, Paige. This young lady went on a 12-point scoring run on the Red Devils in McCamey. And it's out. Definitely want to ice her serve. 14-6 is the score. Coming up is Taylor Ramos. Making it over here, also in the game, folks, production. The production manager, the captain, I dare say, of the Red Devil Broadcasting Network, Don Wyatt.
Yes. No, you're good. That frees me up. I'll try to keep stats and talk a little bit more.
Taylor Ramos, big serve to the corner. And McCamey not going to get to it. 16-6, 10-point lead for the Lady Devils.
This gives me the chills to see our Lady Devils doing this well.
McCamey, ball up underneath. They're going to have to just clear things out here. Opportunity for the Red Devils. Chloe underneath to Connard, and it goes long.
Hard.
16-7. Now, we've made it through the brunt of some of their better servers, but this young lady here, number 5, I remember from the last game, she's got a pretty good arm on her. Underneath, Issa Guerra to Chloe. Backcourt, Issa. Double touch, McCamey. 17-7.
McCamey's going to have a hard time making this up. As long as the Devils don't let up and keep at this, they've got this set.
I just saw Connard look up in here and smile, but you got to love that. They know that this crowd is here for them. Chloe underneath to Chloe Brewer. Back to counter to the corner, and it's going to go long to the outside.
You know, I think last week the crowd kind of took our girls by surprise. I don't think they were quite expecting that turnout. And this week they are using them to their full advantage. They are ready.
Yeah.
They know what's coming. They're used to the crowd. It is definitely home court advantage.
Ward up underneath. Set by Chloe. Back to Ward. Ward's just going to punch it over. McCamey coming back strong. Little spike. Brewer and Connard send it right back to him. 18-8. Webb Devils in charge. Ball to the corner. McCamey does get it to climb over. And Lord, T-Money with the shot. The place explodes.
I don't think Trinity actually meant to get that one over, but it worked.
I just saw Tim Ward smile, and that does not happen often.
That does not happen very often.
Now, let's find Will Langley. Let's see if we can get a smile out of Will, and it's going to be a great night.
Oh,
Brewer going ball to the rafters. 19-9 is the score. Second time the Lady Red Devils lead by 10. And a very good athlete coming up. We're back into the midst of that rotation. Number one for the Badgers. She's going to change it up just a little bit. Slow speed. Ward, big spike. And it's going to go long. Point Red Devils. 20-9.
Impressive score.
And that's going to bring up number 11, Brewer.
Big serve.
Boy, that sounds good. That
does.
Boom.
I love when they do that. There we go.
Ball to the outside. And it's going to be on the line. Point Badgers. You know, referee's got the best view of that right there.
He does have a much better view than I do. I have a bar right in my way, so.
10-20 is the score. Number 15 for the Badgers up to serve. Hadley Fouts in the middle, back row. Issa Guerra cuts it off. Ward underneath. Ramos, and she's going to get there just a little too early. 20-11 now the score. How about this crowd?
This is awesome.
Also, Virginia Evans in the stands tonight. She made it out.
It's good to see her when she can get up and move around and point, be a part of this.
Point Red Devils. Little skip pop over the top by number 20, Skylee Lofton. 21-11 is the score. T-Money Ward serving.
She's doing a lot better this week with her serves. Last week she had a little bit too much power on them, and this week she's got them right in the...
Skylee, big spike. McCamey doing a great defensive job. Taylor Ramos playing at the net. Fouts, big play. Ward's going to punch it over. Big point on the line. Skylee Lofton killing them at the net. There's Ward. Lady Red Devils in the right place
at
the right time.
They are watching that ball closely. Yes!
Big point, Lady Red Devils! 22-11 is the score.
They worked that ball and worked it. I love seeing them when they're not getting frustrated. They're not making little mistakes. They're moving their feet and staying confident and collected.
Ward to the corner. McCamey does get underneath it. Skylee challenging everything at the net. And Skylee with the spike goes into the net. 22-12 is the score. Coming onto the court for the Red Devils in place of Ward, number 4, Alexis Cura.
And again with a 10-point lead.
Skylee, good little skip pop over the top. McCamey's going to have to just send it back. That's going to go long. McCamey making the mistakes today. You know, in McCamey, we shot ourselves in the foot. We shot ourselves in the leg. We shot ourselves in the gut, in the shoulder. They just kept making these little mistakes. But tonight, the Lady Red Devils are the Icemen.
They are.
Playing ice cold. Alexis Cura, big save right there. She's going to have to go down on the digs. Backcourt set, ball out of bounds. Number 17 for the Badgers makes the play. 23-13, now the score.
Yeah, that was a good block by her. There was nobody there to recover it, unfortunately. You can hear our student section.
Ball's up. Isa Guerra underneath. To Alexis, back to Isa, backcourt spike. Coming back to Isa. Isa doing her thing with the set. And Chloe Aguilar had just a little trouble. I think she lost sight of it.
I think so. It came at her just all wrong. Right. Her hands got misplaced.
Ladies, we're right on the threshold, 23-14. And that's going to go out of bounds. Two huge mistakes by a powerful server from McCamey. And she's beside herself. Here we go, folks. Game point for the Red Devils, or set point. And it's over!
Yes.
The Red Devils defeat the Badgers in the first set, 25-14.
Wow.
And you know, you've got to give it to the seventh man.
Absolutely. They're loud, they're proud. You can hear them right now cheering. Girls are on the court clapping along with them.
And McCamey making their way into a hostile climate. Folks, keep an eye on things. We'll be right back at you. Rankin takes the first set, 25-14. Back to the House of Thunder, Rankin, Texas, Devil's Den. Where tonight, the students get an A++++.
They do. The McCamey coach took her girls into the locker room during that little break. Tried to kind of, I'm sure, calm them down, settle them down, get them back leveled out, away from our crowd a little bit, probably.
Paige, I'm going to give this place a nickname over here.
Okay.
I'm going to call it the Pitchfork. No, I'm just kidding. I'm kidding. I mean, it doesn't take much. I'm going to call it Death Valley, Rankin, Texas, because that's what this is, this corner. Absolutely Death Valley for whoever comes out here. We should get, like, a little rafter thing hanging up there.
Death Valley. I like it.
So we got a little break going on. I think it's a rotation deal. Let's get the music kicked back on, get back in the mood of things. Well, I'll tell you what, right, these boys and girls look like they're more ready for a football game, but this volleyball game is bringing the heat. Here we go, McCamey setting up to serve. Underneath, Trinity Ward to Chloe. Chloe Brewer underneath. McCamey with a big spike. Issa underneath it. Chloe Aguilar coming up trying to make something happen. Going to have to get this crowd back into it right there. A little low and a little low on the points. So 0-1 is the score.
Yeah, I fully expect McCamey to answer back a little bit in this set. And our girls have to stay on it and can't slack off.
Big spike there. Chloe Brewer does challenge. Chloe Aguilar, backcourt spike, drops a dime. And it's 1-1 just like that. Back to serve for the Red Devils, number 23, Macy Kynard.
Fans are doing the wave over here.
Kynard with a big serve. Number 4 does manage to get underneath it into the net by number 5 of the Badgers. 2-1 is the score. Number 23, Macy Kynard. Oh, and Chloe Brewer and number 4 get into a net battle. Brewer's going to come up short on this one.
I was laughing because we had your son, Aiden Armendariz, and then Jesse's son, Jesse Armendariz's son down there leading the wave. So there's something about those Armendarizes getting these fans riled up, ready to go.
Well, I wish they'd get louder. McCamey with the serve, ranking up underneath. Sky Lee Lofton with the quick spike. And 5 Badgers looking at the ball like a grenade. Boom, in the middle. 3-2 now the score.
And there's a timeout called by McCamey's coach.
Timeout.
She's going to try to get her girls settled.
That's not a thunderstorm, folks. That is the sound of the fans. Brewer with the serve. A shook-up McCamey Badgers. Can't return it. 4-2 is the score. Crowd back into it. Big spike by McCamey. Chloe Aguilar makes a tremendous dig there. And Sky Lee Lofton, skip pat over the top, big point. 5-2 is the score.
And Sky Lee is on her best game tonight. They're not shutting her down, and so she's just going to keep putting them over.
Number 11, Brewer, good serve over the top. Tests them in the middle. McCamey sends it back over, and 17. And I don't know her name, but that's a daughter of LaWanda McMurray. And she does get the ball crawling over the net. 5-3 is the score. If LaWanda's listening tonight, I want to give a big shout-out to LaWanda. Number 8 for the Badgers serves the ball. Fouts lets it go, and it's going to be long. 6-3 is the score, and that's going to bring up number 6 for the Red Devils, T. Money Ward. Ball over the top. And it's going to be double touch by McCamey. 7-3 is the score.
McCamey getting a substitution in there.
Trinity Ward coming up for a second serve.
Big serve by Trinity. Little over the line.
That's going to be about 6-7 inches over right there. Real close. 7-4 is the score. Onto the court, number 4, Alexis Cura. Now, we've got our two setters out there, so that lets me know Rankin getting ready to bring the heat.
Yes.
And here comes number 18 for McCamey. Good serve. Alexis Cura up underneath. And number 17 for the Badgers making the play.
Good block by her.
7-5 is the score. This, like I said, this number 18, a really good server. Alexis Cura handling it up well, and they found something in number 17 over in the corner. Crowd kind of getting out of it. Need to get these kids back up in this thing. 7-6 is the score. Isagera underneath. Chloe clearing things out. Chloe Aguilar, two fouls. Isagera drops it dead center. McCamey does get up underneath that. Issa with the dive. Taylor Ramos. McCamey in the right place at the right time. Yeah. Skyly to the corner and drops a dime. Bing, bang, biggity boom.
McCamey kept looking for the holes there, and our girls did a great job of covering that, not letting them drop one in there.
8-6 now the score. That's going to bring up number 20, Skyly Lofton. Underneath the Badgers, they're going to have to float it over. No, she comes across with a quick chop spike. Skyly from the back end. And how about Connor double tapping at the net? And she spikes it over. Big point for the Red Devils. Connor, all business right there. 9-6 now the score. Second serve, Skyly Lofton, and got a little English. This one goes out of bounds. 9-7 is the score. McCamey hanging in there. Chloe Aguilar, quick spike. Connard with the spike, drops it dead center. 10-7, now the score. And that's going to bring up zero, Taylor Ramos to the line. I find it easier to say zero instead of saying number.
Number zero?
Yes.
Number zero, Taylor Ramos.
Taylor once again underneath. Brewer with a spike. And that's going to go just long.
Yeah.
And a big shout out to Linnell. You know, you come to these home games, every home game, Linnell is going to be out there doing her work, as well as Miss Lofton, Miss Bunger, and the Mrs. Help me out.
Tucker. Chloe Brewer getting it over the well there.
Issa Guerra doing her thing right there. Chloe back to Issa. And that goes into the white stripe. 10-9. And we've got these kids where we want them. The crowd lulled out on them.
They got a little quiet.
Brewer's going to clear things out.
Good answer by Macy.
Aguilar to Macy. Again. Issa Guerra, Chloe.
Big hit by Macy.
My goodness.
Wow.
I believe there's a coach in Garden City that says, good gravy. 11-9 is the score. Let's do that again.
That was a huge spike by Macy. You can see her. She's kind of licking her lips with a smile on her face. So she knows.
Number three, Chloe Aguilar. Actually, Chloe came up before the game and she said, hey, boo-boo, my name is Chloe Swagular.
Swagular, yes. Chloe Swagular.
Macy Kynard into the net.
I think she was looking for another big spike and just got a little too much on that.
Eleven-10 is the score. 1-point lead for the Red Devils. Number one for the Badgers serving. Issa Guerra underneath to Chloe. Back to Issa. And that's another one into the white stripe. Issa kind of put her hand up right there. Yeah. She's telling herself, hey, Issa, that's enough of that. Let's get going.
Yeah, that was two for her, and you can tell she's frustrated with herself. The thing I love about Issa is she knows she'll get it.
There she goes. She comes right back at it, backcourt spike. Yeah. And it's number 11, Brewer, making the play at the net. 12-11, and that's going to bring us back to number 23, Macy Conard. It's going to crawl over. How about Chloe Aguilar with the huge save right there?
Yes. Ball went through the rafters. Brianna got underneath it, got it back over.
And you got to go all the way back to Chloe Aguilar making a tremendous save.
Yeah.
13-11 is the score. Serving again, Macy Conard.
Chloe Swagular.
There you go. Big serve, Conard. Wow. 14-11. 14-11 with a bullet serve. Number 23, Conard.
Substitution by McCamey.
You know, I think these kids burned a little too much energy out of the gates. There they go.
Yeah, they're getting it. Oh, Skyly with an awesome block.
How about you, Skyly? 15-11.
There's our picture of Skyly up on the screen.
Ball into the rafters. McCamey trying to make something of it. They can clear it out. There's Conard to Chloe. Ward, and Ward goes for the cross spike, goes into the net, however, 15-12. So in this series, our Lady Red Devils kind of finding that net a little more. This is a little more what we did before. 15-12 is the score. And on the court for the Red Devils, number 22, Brianna Abalos, the libero for the Badgers, is serving. And this one's just going to come off the wrong side of her forearm, 15-14. Issa Guerra underneath to Chloe, back to Issa, backcourt spike. McCamey setting something up here. Challenged by number 11, Brewer, and Brewer sets the table, 16-14. You know what that's, remember in the 80s when they say, ooh, ate your lunch? Brewer came up, set the table, told him, would you like anything else to eat, and then ate the meal.
Wow.
She said, no. Brewer underneath, Ward, skip pop over the top.
Good block by
Skyly Lofton, my gosh.
She is on fire tonight.
Skyly Lofton is a whole nother level of an athlete tonight.
Yes.
Brewer, Lofton and Conard are dominating at the net. 17-14. Brewer with the serve. There's Brewer at the back line. Underneath, Chloe. She sets up Ward. Ward skip pop over the top. McCamey in the right place. And that's on the line. Point Badgers.
Close one.
17-15 is the score. 2-point lead. Pivotal game two.
Yes.
In this series.
Lady Devils need to stick with it. They cannot get tired right now. Here's where they need to pull their extra energy and keep at it.
Skyly challenged by 17. It's going to be a point Badgers. Let's see if we can get these kids back into it.
Taylor
Ramos. How about Taylor? Big spike there, 18-16. And that's going to bring up number 6, Trinity Ward.
Let's see what Trinity does. She's trying really hard to get control on her serves. They keep going hard.
Challenges at the back line. McCamey does get up underneath, setting for a spike. And it was challenged by number 20, Skyly, just going to come off of Paul the wrong way. 18-17 is the score.
number 18 for McCamey coming up to serve. Alexis gets under it to Chloe, who sets up Taylor. Big strike. Right on the back line.
Huge spike by number zero, Taylor Ramos.
There's Taylor Ramos. We want to give a shout out to our AB class making our graphics. And not only are these the pictures they made for us, these are up on the wall in the gym as well. So they do a great job, not just with video.
McCamey making another mistake, 20-17. We've got the right person at the service line. It's going to be a timeout.
Timeout by McCamey.
Well, I guess we'll take ourselves a quick little break. Put a little music out there, folks. In game and set number two, the score is Rankin 20, McCamey 17. Do you believe?
I feel the master. I feel them. Y'all ready? They ready. Well, come on. Well, come on. Y'all ready? They ready.
Come to do the rest. Step in the way, multiple shots are going through your chest. You must have gone past the truckers, boy, you was blessed. And I'ma take them out the game, y'all. It ain't no thing, y'all. You want a buck, I rip you up like a chainsaw. The game's raw, boy, please believe it. Keep your Bible with you, cause you gon' be needing Jesus. Beating for chart topping hits. And Archie ain't gon' stop.
Back to the action, the Badgers with a quick spike. It's Kura underneath, Chloe with the set, back to Kynard.
There comes our crowd alive a little bit.
And number 17 for the Badgers, slowly pulling her team back into this. 18-20 is the score. They cannot relinquish this lead.
Bianca.
We need to get word to these kids. We can't hear them. This is the time
to
get loud.
There we go.
Mistake by the Badgers, 21-18. And, you know, in the last game, there weren't this many mistakes by the Badgers. So you got to credit that to this seventh man here in Death Valley.
A little long for Taylor.
Yeah, Taylor's going to come up, make a quick serve. I think with all that energy, she hits it a little too strong.
Yes.
Going to go out past the back line. 21-19 is the score. And this is the first time I've seen this young lady up here serving tonight for the Badgers. She's going to drop it dead center. Abalos underneath. And Brewer, or Kynard actually, got him with a little off speed.
Big spike by Chloe Brewer.
From the corner of the Badgers, Brewer brings it back in to Kynard. McCamey with an opportunity here. And with the changeup, you know, she was going for the spike, came in a little early, but still able to make a play there.
Yeah, Macy was looking for the block, and she just went over Macy where there was an open
20-21. Abalos. So that went from Abalos to Chloe Aguilar to Kynard, and number 17 for the Badgers making the play at the net.
Good block there.
No, it went to the Red Devils.
Oh, I guess it went over.
Okay, let's go.
McCamey.
Then let's go.
She hit it. Number 17 hit it, and it went out.
Abalos makes a great dig right there. Kynard, skip pop.
Yes, nice play by Macy.
And she's going to hit him with that changeup, 23-20. You know, Rankin is going to become one of those places you don't want to come to.
Little power.
Yeah, Chloe Aguilar coming in there. She's serving the ball. Comes in real strong back over the line. That's our last two servers now.
Yes, that's what I was going to. It's actually our last three servers have done that. So.
23-21. Issa Guerra underneath to Chloe. Abalos back court spike. Abalos once again. And it's Kynard!
Oh, yeah.
drops a bomb to the corner.
Yes. Big strike by Macy.
24-21 game point for the Red Devils. This place could come down.
Yes.
And that's game! 25-21. Set number two. You know what this goes to show, Paige, is when you try to do something by yourself, it's a lot harder. You know, you have so many obstacles, so many things you got to face. But when you stand with your family, when you stand with your team, when you stand with your little town, anything is possible.
Yes, yes. These kids are getting into it. They're getting our girls excited. Our girls are used to it. They're getting into it. They're excited, and it's awesome to see.
Let the party begin. We've got one more set to go. If we can pull this one off, Rankin might pull off the upset.
Yes.
In this hostile environment, here in Rankin, Texas, over here in the student section, Death Valley for the Badgers. It's getting wild. It's getting rowdy. They took a page out of Notre Dame's fight song and are shaking the thunder from the sky. Here we go, folks. Paige, we're going into set number three. Can the Lady Red Devils sweep the Badgers?
Well, of course they can. Well, of course they can. Our girls are on the court. They look ready. Here we go. Macy.
First up.
Leading us off.
Red Devils opening up strong, and it's Brewer with a quick spike. 1-0. If you're going to do it, that's how you start. Macy Kynard underneath to Chloe. Back to Brewer into the net. It's going to be 1-1. You know, this crowd experience you get here back in the 80s and 90s, going to Mojo Stadium, Ratliff Stadium, this was the problem. You know, you'd go there, you'd bring your town in there, and they would just decimate you with noise. And, you know, you're getting that out here in Rankin today.
Yes, you are. Good little set by Skyly.
Yeah, how about number 20, Skyly Lofton, having right one of the greatest games she's ever had. And she's already a great player.
She is. She absolutely is. She is on point every single play tonight.
Issa Guerra underneath. Skyly to the corner, and it's out of there. Now, the kid's, you know, raising that flag a little too quick. 2-2 is the score.
Skyly saw a hole there, and she tried to get in there just a little hard. We could only move that gray line occasionally.
That'll bring up number 15 for the Badgers. Skyly makes a saving play. Red Devils are going to be into the net. And I believe that one's going to be number 20, Skyly. 2-3, first lead, I believe, in three sets for the Badgers.
Yes, it is.
Fouts underneath to Aguilar. Back to Issa. Beautiful backcourt spike. Look at Issa jumping up and down out there. That's motivating.
That is the hit she's been trying to get. She got mad at herself last set because she missed it twice. And that's exactly, that is Issa. That's why we love her, because she comes back and gets it right.
3-3 is the score. Ward on the serve. And it's going to be double touch by the Badgers. You know, I've seen that quite a few times, but it's being called against another team now.
Yes, it's usually us. Oh, big hit by Trinity.
McCamey underneath. Issa. Chloe. And then Ramos with the big shot. Ramos changes it up right there, slows it down, drops it over the net. 5-3. Ramos, only a sophomore out there, getting big things done. And that one's going to go just out of bounds.
Smart call by McCamey to let that one go. It was just over the line.
So it's 5-4, and it's going to be a tight game right here. And well, it should be. Issa underneath Chloe Aguilar. Back to Issa, and this one's going to come off the bottom part of her arm there. 5-5 is the score.
And McCamey is not going to let Rankin have this one. They're going to fight for it tooth and nail. So Rankin's going to have to step it up and play smart. They can't just assume McCamey's going to back down to them.
Fouts tries to make the play. And, you know, between her and Issa right there, I think it was just a little miscommunication.
I think so.
5-6 is the score. So we got a couple early mistakes in. Let's go ahead and move past that and get things done. Fouts up underneath to Aguilar. Ramos, and Ramos hits into the net. Three mistakes in a row by the Red Devils. 5-7 is the score.
And they're going to have to shut this down right now.
Aguilar.
There's Skyly.
Number 20, Skyly Lofton. Skyly comes in there gracefully, just sets the ball over the top. Skip pop, big point, 6-7 is the score. And Skyly going to the line to serve. McCamey underneath. Skyly. Aguilar. Kynard. Skyly once again. And we've got Ramos to the corner, and it's long.
A little long.
Four mistakes for the Red Devils as a team, playing as a whole. So they're going to have to, you know, kind of shake that out, rattle that up. I know they're a little nervous. They know what's at stake here.
Do.
6-8 is the score.
We're going to call that one to McCamey. 9-6. You talked earlier about this server number 18, and looks like we're going to sub in Chloe. like there's a little bit of a discussion here. Okay, that was going to be Rankin's point. So score is going to be Rankin 7, McCamey 8.
You know, I just got word, you know, as this game's going on, it's 7-9, Rankin down by 2, and that one went long out of bounds. Then on my fantasy football league, I got to give up my defense because somebody called it before it was time to get it. Wow. Brianna Abalos makes a big play there. Connard coming back with a spike. Abalos once again. Brewer punches to the corner.
Yes. Good hustle by McCamey. Just couldn't quite get there.
Yeah, that young lady, number 18,
yes.
She's a strong player for
good
the Badgers.
By her.
8-9, Chloe Aguilar up to the helm. Here come your Red Devils.
Chloe Swaguilar.
McCamey going to have to just push it back over the top. Brewer to Connard. McCamey doing a really good job of getting that back in play. Oh. Abalos, she's getting help from Issa. And number 23, Connard, making a great save right there. How about Issa and Ward working together? And it's going to be a net call for the Red Devils. So more mistakes in this third set than we've had the whole
definitely.
Game.
You can tell our Lady Devils, they're getting tired. They've been playing hard and playing smart, and so they're going to have to just step it up a little bit. They can't give this set away. Good.
Boom! Now, I was turned away. Who got that spike?
That was Macy.
9-10 is the score. Number 23, Macy Kynard coming to the line. And it's a crawl over. Lady Luck singing a song for the Lady Devils. 10-10 is the score.
Big serve by Macy. McKinney does get it back over.
Abalos makes a play. Aguilar to Ward. And Ward dominates on the cross court. 11-10. Lady Red Devils once again have the lead. And Kynard's going to serve this one into the middle of the net. 11-11 is the score. Got a message here. Let's look this up real quick. Number 20, Skyly, trying to make a play for the Red Devils. Hey, I just got some great news from Will Langley. Third and fourth grade flag football went undefeated this year.
Good.
How about those
them.
Red Devils? The last game they just played was against our foes, the Garden City Bearcats.
Nice.
I'm told by Will it was a great game, and Rankin won 24-13. On their own field, Red Devils shutting down the Bearcats.
Nice. Congratulations to them. We are very proud of them.
I'm told that was the battle for the pitchfork.
All right. There we go, the pitchfork.
Ward setting something up here. Chloe Aguilar long to the backside, and that's going to go out of bounds.
Rankin's going to have to shut McCamey down right here, and there's going to be a timeout called by Coach Butler.
Yeah, good time for a timeout.
She does not want to let McCamey get on a run here, so she's going to shut him down, encourage our girls, get them back in it, and hopefully stop the momentum that McCamey has.
11-14, and you know, Paige, you know, when they call in something like that, don't take that lightly.
No.
You know, your third and fourth grade teams going out there dominating, defeating. You know, this could be a situation, and I'm going to go ahead and call it now. This is a situation where this group of third and fourth graders may not see their first loss till they get around high school.
Wow.
I'm saying they're going undefeated in junior high.
Wow.
I'm saying they're going undefeated all the way.
Mighty clever.
Well, you know, if you believe you're good, you're going to be great.
You're right.
And if you believe you're great, you're going to be phenomenal. And these kids have what it takes to be phenomenal.
You are absolutely right.
Back to the action. McCamey with the serve. 3-point lead for the Badgers.
There we go.
Skip pop by Trinity Ward.
You can hear the fans yelling for Chloe Brewer. Big served. Chloe sets up Skyly, who gets it over. Cammy does get under it. Number 17, big hit.
Skyly, there it is.
Get back to her.
Number 20, Skyly.
Wow.
Hey, Will Langley and the coaches of the Red Devils, if you guys are still listening, get a list of the kids together.
Yes.
And definitely want to announce them this Friday's football game against Grady. Oh. Because something so grand cannot go unnoticed. We've
yes.
got to get them. You know, these kids got to know you love them. They got to know that you're supporting them. They got to know that no matter what they do, they've got the Red Devil family behind them.
Absolutely.
Number 15 or 19 for the Badgers serving.
Oh.
Issa gets a hand on it. It's going the opposite way. So we're kind of falling behind
yes.
here. 13-16, 3-point lead for the Badgers. I'm sorry, I'm stepping on your court.
Right. Just pulling my head down.
Issa Guerra underneath it. Aguilar. Back to Skyly. McCamey's going to clear things out. Good dive there by Chloe. You know, Red Devils needing to make more opportunistic plays, and it's going to be Red Devils into the net.
Yeah, Taylor there trying to get a block and just didn't quite get it off.
13-17. Chloe. Skyly!
Right.
And yes. Skyly sends a message to McCamey.
Skyly,
I have arrived. 14-17 is a score. Ward. Little skip pop over the top. Red Devils up underneath it. Taylor wisely clearing things out.
Big block by Skyly.
Yeah, I think Skyly kind of shook her right there. Oh, long
hard.
To the backside. 14-18 is the score. That's going to bring out the libero for the Badgers, number 11.
Look at you learning how to say that word.
I thought I was saying it wrong on purpose.
Christy Aiken will be so proud of you.
Issa Guerra underneath to Chloe Aguilar. Back to Taylor. Red Devils making a great
yes.
save there. Issa Aguilar. Skyly, little skip pop. Badgers, we're waiting on that one. Skyly makes a great play. Oh, and it's going to come a little low into the
yeah.
net. 14-19. Badgers leading by 5. Skyly once again. McCamey, good save there. Taylor Ramos from the corner. Fouts underneath. Aguilar. And number, I believe that's 13 for the Badgers making the play. 14-20.
Yes.
Skyly kind of lost her footing, but
yeah.
never lost the ball. She gets it over. Issa Garrett, great play. And Red Devils and Badgers battling for this point.
There we go.
And Taylor Ramos prevails at the net.
You know, two or three times there, Taylor hit it, and 17 was answering back at her, and Taylor finally got it through her and into that hole.
So it's 15-20. Red Devils down by 5. Skyly Lofton up to the plate. We're going to need some mistakes from the Badgers here. There's one. You got Ramos and you've got Connor jumping right there. 17 had her eye on him, and that's what caused that. 16-20, 4-point lead. Skyly Lofton. She's going to test out that libero into the rafter.
Good answer by Taylor.
Oh! Connor going to get a little surprised by that one. I think it came back a little quicker than she was expecting. Well, back onto the court for the Red Devils, our libero, number 8, Issa Guerra. Red Devils diamond defensive formation. Strongest server on the court right now for the Badgers, number 18. Kura makes quick work of it. And somebody's in the net. Badgers! We've got a Badger in the wire. 17-21. By my calculations, that's 4 points.
Yes, that would be correct. 4 points.
Zero, Taylor Ramos behind the line. Tremendous serve by Ramos. Boy, that is a serve beyond her years.
Yes.
18-21.
She is fired up. Same spot again.
Wow. McCamey does manage to get that over.
Oh, gosh.
And Taylor herself dives for it, tries to make the play. It's going to be a little short there. 18-22 now the score. Onto the court for the Red Devils, number 22, Brianna Abalos. Chloe Aguilar makes a play. McCamey does get up underneath it. To the corner, Kura's ready. Brewer. McCamey setting some for something. Issa Guerra doing her thing. And it's Kynard to the center.
Yes.
Double touch, Badgers. 19-22. 3-point lead. That's going to bring up Aguilar.
You can hear the fans getting back into it on those serves. Oh, yes.
And it's going long to the outside. Look at Issa Guerra. She was ready, but she's going to let it slide. It does go long. 20-22.
Oh, McCamey's going to take a timeout.
Boy, this game's had everything. Yes. I'd sure love to be able to say we close the door right now. Because if you keep playing, you never know what's going to happen. But I think we've got what it takes. I know we've got what it takes.
You know, this timeout couldn't have come at a better time for us, honestly. It gives our girls a chance to rest just a minute. You can tell they're tired. They recollect themselves. So, honestly, I'm not sure that McCamey did themselves any favors calling this timeout. We'll see.
So, 20-22 is the score, folks. We'll be right back at you in just a minute. McCamey, big spike, and that's the first one of the day. Number 8 coming in strong. And it's a good time to have it. 20-23 is the score. Red Devils not able to break that 5 and 3 point lead. Brianna Abalos, Aguilar, Kynard.
Yes!
21-23. Red Devils clawing their way out of the hole.
Yes.
Climbing that ladder.
You see with a good serve there.
Spike by McCamey. Brewer with help from Aguilar. Can they clear? It does. Abalos, big help on that one. And it goes long. 22-23.
All right, Macy coming up to serve. That is who we need.
She's going to go long to the right side, and everybody was holding their breath there. The score, 24-22. Rankin, do you believe? Abalos. Ball's up in the air. They're back across. Someone in the net. Not called. And they didn't want to call it. Neither one of the refs wanted to call the young lady in the net. 22-25 is the score, and that's the game. So, folks, we're going to go to a little music. We'll be right back at you where it's 2-1. Sometimes it is what it is, and sometimes it are what it are. It's 2-1. The Lady Red Devils leading. Isa Guerra underneath. Ward coming to help out. Brewer is going to clear things out for the Red Devils. Double touch by the Badgers.
That is what we need to start off with.
1-0 Rankin. As you saw from the last game, every point is going to count.
Yes.
Kynard with a serve. Number 17 doing a tremendous job for the Badgers. And here comes Brewer, skip pop over the top. McCamey in the right place. That's going to go long to the outside. 2-0.
And, you know, being on this side, we can see our girls and we can see them working, the girls at the net on the other team. Their skills have really come a long way this year.
Big serve by number 23, Kynard. That's going to put Rankin up 3-0. And this is how you start the fourth set. Once again, Kynard. McCamey, one option, clear things out. That's Chloe Aguilar coming up. Ward with the quick spike. McCamey going to the backside, under the net, 4-0. Here we go, folks. Number 23, Macy Conard, continuing to serve. Abalos. To Aguilar. Ward clears things out. A lot of action going on the court. And number 20, Skyly, with a quick spike. McCamey over the top. Neither team wanting to make a mistake right now. Chloe Aguilar over the top. And it's number 20, Skyly! That right there was just good, clean, solid, smart volleyball.
Yes, that is exactly what our Lady Devils need to be doing, is just playing it till the opening comes and taking it.
5-0 is the score. Conard picks her spot. Ball over the top. Abalos with the save. Big and number 20, Skyly. Wow. Wow, Skyly is just having a lights out game.
She is the name of the game tonight. Oh, Trinity,
Ward.
Good answer. Yes.
Look at number 6, Ward, double clutching, knocking it down. 7-0 is the score.
Oh, and there is a timeout by McCamey. This is exactly how we wanted to come out in the fourth set.
Absolutely. They've got them rattled.
Yes.
They've got them shook.
Yes.
If I had the song, I'd play a little Shake, Rattle, and Roll. Number 23, Conard, up to the line. McCamey, number 17, makes a statement.
She has been trying to work that all night. Finally paid off for her.
7-1 is the score. There's a two-player change for the Badgers. Number 15, up to serve.
That was a good 7-point run there by Macy.
Abalos underneath. She's going to try to get underneath the ball there. Not going to quite get it. 7-2 now the score. You know, in a game where so much can change so quickly.
Yes, we don't want to make those mistakes.
15 back for her second serve. Abalos underneath it to Aguilar. Brewer!
Oh, yes!
Point!
Beautiful spike.
What Devils? Need a little action replay there. 8-2 is the score.
There was a beautiful spike to that back line by her.
Brewer's going to hit him a little change of speed. It's a high roller over the top. Aguilar saves it from the corner. Chloe Brewer back to Skyly. McCamey coming in strong. And Skyly sends it right back at him. Brewer. Aguilar, Lofton, both teams doing a great job in the middle right now. That's going to go out of bounds. 9-2 is the score.
And really, there is no comfort zone in here on a lead against McCamey. We cannot stop pushing.
Badgers up underneath. Brewer makes the dive. Ramos is going to get called with a two-touch. First time Rankin's had that call tonight against them.
Especially that was Taylor Ramos, you said. She doesn't get that call very often. She's pretty good with her sets. So.
Yeah, and I think that's actually the first time I've seen that called on Ramos. 9-3 is the score. The libero for the Badgers serving. Little mistake in there by the Red Devils. 9-4 now the score. Circle formation for the Red Devils. Fouts dead center. Ball's going to go into the net. 10-4, 6-point lead. Number six, Trinity Ward, coming
easy
to the line.
Easy Trinity, easy Trinity. There she goes.
Ball's up into the rafters. McCamey up underneath. Good clear out. Fouts underneath. Aguilar. Backside to
yes,
Skyly.
Yes, ma'am. Good hit by Skyly.
Deadly combination. 11-4. Now the score. Crowd thinning out just a little bit. I think they're all eating nachos right now.
Trying to get their hands on the last batch of french fries.
Ward with another good serve, dead center. Ward up underneath, ball is going to come off her forearm. It's going to go out of bounds, 11-5 is the score. Badgers with the serve. And here we go, folks, number 18 for the Badgers coming to the line. Now, we've seen her get hot before.
Yeah, she is definitely their top server, and so the Lady Devils need to be ready. You can see Issa moving, she moved into exactly the right spot there, ready for that. Just off the palm of her hand.
Yeah, Issa's going to come for the backcourt spike. Didn't quite get a hold of that one. 11-6 is the score. This is not the server you want on the court right now.
No.
She's going to go long. Fouts going to get underneath it. Ramos clears things out. Aguilar. Lofton. Aguilar.
Yes.
And Aguilar with a skip pop over the top drops it. Dynamite. They just gave the point to the visitors, though. So it must have been a net call on the Red Devils. Or a carry.
We don't know what that call was.
Fouts up underneath. Aguilar to Skyly. Two-touch against Chloe, so the call is starting to come against the Red Devils now. Maybe we're getting a little too laxed out there.
That is not what we need to happen.
Issa. And Ramos making a little mistake out there in the corner. That's going to make it 11-9.
Yeah, Coach Butler is going to call a timeout right here and get our girls settled down. It seems like when our girls get these calls against them like that, they get discouraged and get frustrated with themselves, and that's when they start making the mistakes, and that's exactly what happened. So hopefully Coach Butler can get them settled down and back in their game.
All right, folks, we'll be right back at you in just a few. To the action, number 18 for the Badgers. Fouts up underneath. That's a good start. Cura gets it up, and Fouts sends it back over. Aguilar to Skyly, and
yes.
Skyly sends it to number 18. Message sent. 12-9 is the score.
That's exactly what we needed to do, was shut down that server and turn the tide a little bit.
12-9 is the score. Number 20, Skyly Lofton, stepping up to the plate. Underneath are the Badgers, and it's going to be a two-touch. McCamey, 13-9 is the score.
Big serve by Skyly.
Fouts up underneath there. Taylor Ramos sends it home. 14-9.
And our girls are on point with their spikes tonight. I got a whole list of spikes. I'm out of room on my spike section of the page here.
Number three, Aguilar is going to go into the net. 14-10. Paige, we want to give a special shout-out right now going all the way up to Lubbock, the Hub City, Texas. There's a man over there and his family. They listen to every game, part of the Guerra family of Mindy and JoJo, Mindy's dad. Big shout-out to Arthur Garcia listening out in Lubbock. And he's bringing luck to the Red Devils. Devils pick up a point there as we mentioned the name Arthur Garcia. 15-10 is the score. Taylor Ramos to the line.
Good serve by her. And McCamey not able to get a handle on it.
16-10, 6-point lead for the Red Devils.
The Lady Devils cannot get comfortable with this lead, though. They've got to keep carrying it and hold McCamey right here in this 10 area.
McCamey gets underneath the ball. It's into the rafters. Clearing things out. Kira makes quick work of it. To Chloe. To Connard. Connard a little too relaxed. Goes into the net. 16-11. And that's one of those ones that she saw it go. She knew it, you know, what had happened right there. Look at this. We've got Coach Bala out there getting onto the girls. That's good right there. And it must be paying off because Connor just dropped a bomb. McCamey does get in the right place, though. How about Avalos with the big save? And that's into the fishing pole. Automatic point, Red Devils. 17-11, 6-point lead. Number three, Chloe Aguilar to the line. Aguilar drops it dead center. Avalos getting there, but it's going to come off her forearm.
Yeah, that was a good hustle on her part, just not able to get there.
And number one for the Badgers, serving dead center, Avalos underneath, Brewer, Ward. McCamey with an opportunity here. No, it's going to go long to the outside, and that's going to be a Red Devil point. to 12 is the score.
Coach Butler's going to.
You know, Red Devils might be out of place here. So, you know, everybody really cautiously watching. Looks like it's going to be okay, though. Onto the court, it's going to be number 20, Skyly Lofton. 23, Connard to the service. Little curveball right there. McCamey does get up underneath it. Good-looking spike by the Badgers.
Good hustle.
Aguilar.
Chloe Brewer.
That was Chloe to Chloe.
Yes.
And the Red Devils shut the Badgers down at the net. 19-12 is the score. That's going to go long to the backside. McCamey had a good eye on that one. So 19-12 now. Coming onto the court, number 15 for the Badgers. Number 15, a very fair server. Underneath, Avalos. And Chloe and Issa kind of both went for the ball at the same time. They're going to collide there lightly. 19-14 is the score. And number 15 picks up a quick point. And going to go into the white stripe, onto the floor, point Red Devils. Woo, Paige, here we go, 20-14.
Kind of waiting to see if McCamey's going to call a timeout. Coach Botla's pacing the floor.
Coach Botla's out there getting onto the girls
she is.
Now.
She is.
Chloe Aguilar, ball in the air. Issa Guerra knocks it dead center.
Yes.
Skyly Lofton making the play. Ramos with a spike! Bing, bang, biggity boom! And the Red Devil wave just keeps on rolling. Maroon and white, dynamite.
Yes.
21-14, number 11, Chloe Brewer to the helm. Chloe, a little bit of a changeup on it. Comes in slow over the top. Red Devils get the spike. Yes. Number 20, Skyly Lofton with another big block at the net. 22-14. And Brewer with another serve. She puts a little top spin on it. Wow. Goes to the backside. Point, Red Devils.
Yes.
That was a very calculated top spin serve by Brewer.
You know, Coach Butler here may have found a new tool in her tool belt to stay on these girls and get out on the – she is almost on that court.
Another top spin serve by Brewer, 24-14, 10-point lead. Red Devils, let's get this.
Student section has their fingers up. One more is what they're cheering. Fans are on the – clapping.
Ball's in the air. And it's out of bounds! Red Devils win!
Yes!
25-14 in the fourth set. 3-1. The Lady Red Devils have pulled off the upset of the year.
Yes.
Nowhere in the state of Texas, nowhere in America has there been a greater upset than what just transpired here in Upton County, Rankin, Texas, tonight.
Yes.
A true David and Goliath situation. And once again, Goliath goes down 2-0.
The boys are holding signs up to the girls. The girls are all smiles, holding up hearts. They are excited. There's a few tears out there. They are excited.
Big ups to the crowd. You know, you've got to give at least 2-3 games of this action going on in there to the crowd. Amazing game.
Absolutely. So now the girls play Four Sand Friday at 4. We won't be broadcasting that one. We're going to try to – we talked it out with Coach Botla, and we're going to stay here and broadcast the boys' district football game that's equally important. But and then next week our girls take on Sterling City, and that is the game that we all want to be here for.
But let me ask you a question. Is that game at home?
It is at home, and it will decide what – place we end up in.
Okay.
The
Red Devil Stadium seats exactly 720 people.
So there we go. We can fill the home side, the visitor side, the foyer, wherever we need to be. We want everybody here.
So from all of us out here at Red Devil Studios to all of you, the Miracle Makers, Lady Red Devils with the big win. Folks, we'll get you on the next one. We love you and good night.